guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know it's been a minute, but I'm back now. Today we're going to be focusing on two inner thigh stretches with the help of the wall.
Now, before we dive into the video, I just want to explain a little bit about anatomy so you are understanding which part of the body you're using and all of that, okay? Now, most of the asanas, we are working on external rotation like Baddha Konasana, okay? So, your external rotation is your piriformis muscle plus five other muscles. Now, even though this is external rotation, if your inner thigh, which is your internal rotation, is a little bit tight, doing Baddha Konasana or even a split is going to be a little bit challenging, okay? Because now again, your internal rotation comprises of your gluteus minimus, part of your gluteus medius, now the upper frontal thighs and your abductor muscles, which is your inner thighs. Now, if these are tight, of course, asanas like your Baddha Konasana or even splits is going to be challenging for you. And then when you want to do advanced asanas like taking your leg behind your head will almost be impossible and you'll be very angry with yourself because your basic asanas are not happening. So what I want you all to do is we're going to dive into the video. You want to come as close to the wall as you can, okay? That means you want to try and get your butt touching the wall. Now this is very important. Straighten your legs as much as you can and open your legs to wherever you can. Now if you can't open your legs all the way down here, doesn't matter, you go to whichever level you are comfortable. So could be here, could be here, or even could be here. Eventually, gradually, over a period of time, your legs, your hips, everything will open up gradually once you let go of your fears and inhibitions and whatever's holding you back in your mind. Eventually your hips will also work in that way. Your second thing that you can do is look at this motion that I'm doing. As I inhale, I'm pushing my hip out. As I exhale, I'm taking it in. Now, I understand that it might look extremely sexual. That means you really need to, one, grow up and get out of your perverted head, because I'm actually and genuinely showing you all things in a very sexual way, yeah? But if you're still stuck in your misogynistic thinking, well, no one can help you, not even God can come down and help you, but only you can help yourself. Anyway, other than that rant, you can stay here however long you can. Once you feel like your inner thighs are burning and dying, stay for a couple of seconds longer and come back into a comfortable position. Now here's the thing, you can do this anyway. If you feel like I'm getting bored and I'm constantly thinking, you can listen to music, or as you can see, you can pick up a book and start reading, okay? Because sometimes the pain can get a little intense and you can use things to distract you, okay? So you can even watch TV. But whatever you're doing, just try and make sure that you want to try and get the legs as lower and lower. Now, I would suggest, sometimes I've even fallen asleep over here, okay? And then when I've gotten up, my legs were numb. So I would suggest start off slow. First, start for like 3 minutes. In the beginning, 3 minutes also will seem a lot, okay? Start for 3 minutes. And then, as I always say, build yourself up from there. You can do about 15 minutes in this position comfortably, yeah? Also, something you can keep in mind is you can flex and point your feet so that your muscle will be activated, or you can rotate the leg. Now, as you rotate your leg, you will notice that the legs also want to go down. So anything that is holding you back in your hips or your inner thighs, you're releasing it out, well, slowly. I'm telling you, it may seem like, oh my God, I'm chilling, but it's freaking painful. Now, to come out of this, what you can do is you can take your hands placed on the thighs and slowly, little by little, push it all the way up, okay? If you're comfortable, you can just use your inner thigh strength and gently get your legs up. From there, you can hug your legs in towards you for however long you want. From there, we're going to come onto our fours. And as you come onto your fours, you're going to open the knees as much as you can. And now you want to try and sink that hip down close, as close as you can to your heels or your ankles, okay? Now see, the idea is you want to try and get the inner thigh to touch, which is going to be a little challenging, and for a lot of people you could be almost all the way up, okay? For me, this is really painful because, and ideally you want to try and get that butt all the way back to where the wall is, yeah? As you can see, even for me it's a very challenging and painful. From here you can do that same movement of taking the butt up and down. This is going to help you contract the muscle and release the muscle as well. From here, you're going to get your hands next to the side of your chest and we're going to try and move back and forward as much as you can. You can see that this is a bigger movement than the first one. Yeah? You're going to go back and come forward. After you've done this, you want to try and take that butt all the way back as much as you can towards the wall. Another thing you want to remember is you want to remember to try and keep that butt as low to the floor as you can, which is going to be a little challenging because it will want to come up. Yeah, again, this is just opening up your inner thigh, and with the wall your legs can't go here and there. Believe me, this really burns, as you can see with my facial expressions and well my voice. But yeah, remember, butt wants to go down as much as you can. You can even either, I would suggest, place something on your butt if you can, or if someone is there, ask, they can push it gently. But do not force, yeah, because if something can snap and tear if you go very intense. From there, you can come all the way up. Now, as you come up, you can take your hands slightly forward. And now, as you do this, roll the shoulders back. And you want to try and get that inner thigh to touch the floor. This is the first time it actually touched. See you all next week with another video. Okay, bye.